On the other hand, Sri Tarun Barma, the Land Council for the Oriental Bank of Commerce, submitted that the petitioners have an officious remedy of filing an application under Section 17 of the Act before the Debt Recovery Tribunal. In support of his submission, the Land Council has placed reliance upon a decision of the Supreme Court in United Bank of India versus Satyavati Tandon and others, 2010 SCC 110. It was urged that after the declaration of the account of the borrower as NPA, the bank has already filed a suit before the tribunal for recovery of its amount, and that the tribunal has also issued an interim order restraining the borrower from annuiting the properties, including the properties which is sought to be released through the present writ petition. The Land Council contended that the appropriate remedy for the petitioner is to move an appropriate application before the Debt Recovery Tribunal, which would be considered, and appropriate orders would be passed by the tribunal. The Land Council contended that consequently it was not a fit case for the writ court to entertain such petitions. The Land Council submitted that the concurrence given by the Oriental Bank of Commerce for release of the property of petitioner number 1 was subject to fulfillment of certain terms and conditions at the time when the account of the borrower was standard and regular, but during the consideration of the matter, the borrower did not maintain financial discipline and the account of the borrower became NPA. As such, in the charged circumstances, the bank was not bound to honor the concurrence since the conditions were not fulfilled by the petitioners. The Land Council submitted that the borrower has failed to maintain the financial discipline and have made no effort to regularize the account, and consequently the request for substitution of the mortgaged properties could not be acceded to. The Land Council further submitted that the account of the borrower was declared NPA as per the Reserve Bank of India guidelines, and since the borrower did not make any effort to regularize its accounts, proceedings under the Act was initiated. The Land Council contended that a valid notice under Section 13 of the Act has been issued, and the objection of the borrowers and other guarantors were considered and rejected under Section 13 of the Act, and only thereafter a notice under Section 13 of the Act was issued, and now an application for recovery of the account amount has been filed under Section 19 of the Recovery of Debts Due to Banks and Financial Institutions Act 1993. The Land Council submitted that the plea of the petitioners that the respondent's bank had wrongly declared the account of the borrower as NPA is misconceived, in as much as such plea could not be raised for the first time in a writ jurisdiction, as the said plea was never raised before the bank nor was raised in their objection filed under Section 13 of the Act.